van een of andere platenmaatschappij. Ze doen het liever op eigen kracht en met eigen inzichten. Het voordeel hiervan is een eigen en iedere keer weer verrassende sound. Zoals hun laatste cd, Let Them Eat Cake. Lola da Musica ging naar de Poolcirkel en zocht ze op. De Noorse band Motorpsycho.
The music.
When I listen back to stuff that we have done, I sort of get surprised every now and then of the, you know, the moodiness of it, the darkness in a way, the melancholy, whatever you want to call it. I don't know if that's influenced, you know, by the city or the environment that we live in. The musical stuff you had in this city was, you know, the poodle heavy type stuff, and you know, the 80s big hair bands that had bad production and huge drum sounds. And that was, Trondheim was sort of the capital of that type of music in Norway. And we knew that if we ever wanted to sell records, we'd have to sing in English, that's one thing. We would also have to make sure that we could actually tour abroad. Because, I mean, in Norway there's like 3 or 4 places that you could play back then, you know. So that's the place you could play is more or less the students or college towns, which is Tromsø, Trondheim, Bergen, Oslo, and you have a few very small places where you can also play where there are some local student thingy happening. So it's a huge country, but it doesn't really have too much happening in it. I guess you could say that Motorpsycho is the biggest small band in Norway, in a way. We're not mainstream in the sense that we sell shitloads of records, but we're mainstream enough to actually be able to live off it. We always sell out our shows, whether it's 400 or 1200 or 1500 capacity shows. And we sell approximately 15,000 records in Norway, which is not bad, I mean, considering that there's only like 4 million Norwegians altogether, anyway. So small but big in a way, and I think we've meant a lot to people because we were sort of the first band that took our music abroad in a bigger sense, and sort of broke through in Germany or whatever you want to call what we've done down there. And sort of we opened a lot of pathways, and we showed the Norwegian music world that you don't really have to rely on the majors to be able to do your own thing. You don't have to, you know, go through the machine. You can actually get your own contact net. You can do what you need to do.
Get up, go and cut those tapes.
you're nothing to her now. 11 years all up in smoke. Was it really just a joke? Mistakes too small a word. So small, I've never seen you quite so small.
Vi har fremdeles Motorpsycho I studio. Hva heter den sangen igjen?
Big Surprise.
Ja.
Vi spilte jo inn 24 låter, og av dem så var det jo, vi måtte jo gjøre en liten seleksjon da. Men vi gir jo ut en minialbum senere I år, med litt røffere saker hvis folk synes vi har blitt for...
Snill.
Ut.
Ja, men det var liksom litt for å rendyrke hele stemningen, for det så vi har en tendens til å bestandig skal vise absolutt alle sidene av oss selv på hver eneste plate. Og nå tror jeg at folk som liker at vi spiller rock, de vet at vi kan spille rock, og de som nå har lyst til å høre litt pop og litt balsam for ørene, så kan de jo prøve å høre nye plater, så får de høre en ny side av oss.
Fikk dere taxi opp hit, eller?
And here's the official entrance to the Svartlamoen with our own little crest. The squatters. I don't know. It's some sort of abomination. It's I think it's the local the Trondheim crest, and then it has this squat cat on top of it. You have all kinds down here. You have artists. You have punks. You have people out playing bands. You have. I mean, when we started out, we have our office up here. Our producer used to live here. The guy who does our covers used to live here. We all used to live down here or in the neighborhood here. And it's just, you know, all the facilities. And over there is Dura, which is where we rehearse. Oops. Watch the door. This is the office. This is the Norwegian Grammy Awards that we got. These are bronze. It's a Jew harp, one of those things. I can't do that.
What kind of awards?
It's the record business sort of. It's like the Grammy in the States, I guess. We got one for best hard rock album of the year. That was Blizzard. And then the other one we got for the best rock, like normal rock album for the album that came after it, Angels and Demons at Play. So. I mean, they're not. They don't really mean anything. We don't, you know, get better paid or anything like that. But it's important to our grandparents. I mean, it's there's a lot of status connected with this type of stuff. This is us years ago. This is Death Prod, our producer, when he used to be in the band. Schnau with long hair, Gebert with long hair, and me with long hair and a bull ring in my nose. Not pop stars yet.
And when was that?
93 or 94, 93. That's a check that we got because the song of the millennium would be played for 24 hours from 12 noon on the 31st until 12 noon on the 1st of January. This is the royalty money that we get off it.
How much is that?
175,000 kroner. straight into the pocket, and we didn't do anything. It was the fans that voted it, so we're really happy. They did a good job. The song by Europe, I don't know if you remember them, The Final Countdown, that was sort of the second best song. So I think the Europe fan club and the Motorpsycho fan club had some sort of contest going, you know, putting up links on the net, you know, on porn pages and all of that. But we won the thing in the end. I was telling, it was, that sort of meant more than these things, because it was the fans that decided it, and it's not some sort of journalist or whatever record business executive that decided that we would get it. Now we're going to Hurra, Dura, it's our rehearsal room. It's just down here. This Dura used to be a submarine bunker during the war, and they sort of put various businesses and stuff in there now. And there's, it's really well soundproofed. I mean, the walls are like 6 meters, so we can rehearse down there anytime we like, which helps.
But what was this bunker used for?
Right here, the submarines used to drive in. And so you had like, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 submarine gates. And that's the reason why they built it so thick, I guess, so that they could sort of control the North Sea with it. And it worked. It did. So all the convoys that went from the States to Murmansk up in Russia were sort of attacked from here. It's a lot more quiet now. I mean, you could still see in the late 60s the wrecks of the submarines here, but I think they towed them out and sank them. So this is where we work, and it's open. We'll be right back. we are three very different kind of persons. So and we have different talents, I guess. Bent is he's been writing most of the songs, and probably he's a burning guy, you know. And yeah, we usually say like the Spinal Tap that Schnee is what is it, melting water between us, you know, he's burning and I am probably icy.
What makes Bent burning then?
His intensity, you know, when he's into something, you know, he's really there, completely. And I am also that, but you can be it in separate ways. That was a very nice thing for a drummer, you know, or also for a musician. You know, when you're a kid, you see all these big heroes in the music magazines, and they are standing there with their own signature series. So, and this I got made myself, so they are exactly as the way I want them to be. People probably think that I use very heavy drumsticks, I guess, but this is, you can feel it. It's almost like air inside, and they are quite long. This symbol here, I actually bought in Eindhoven.
What's that?
It's the moose symbol. So there is a freak in Eindhoven. What's he called? But he's making gongs and all kind of symbols.
Can you use it?
Yeah, I use it for a couple of tours, and I thought I would take it to the rehearsal room today. It's very special. But when you play different kind of places, you have different kind of sounds on it. But it's hard to do with my finger as a cymbal stand. When I play around with the banjo, you know, I never learned any chords or things, how it should really be played. So I just play it my own way and make small naivistic melodies, which I think sounds nice. And I tune the banjo the way I want. So, but I'm teaching my girlfriend to play banjo, and she has to learn all the chords the right way. So, but I can do it my own way. So, can play a little tune which is gonna be on my little Gebhard Plays With Himself album. And it sounds something like this. Different kind of things to make people adapt to your music. You know, if you only give them one kind of expression, it gets boring for the ears, and they can't take it. So we need to put more soft things and more heavy things and just mix it, I think, to make it.
Who's in charge developing the creative ways of?
That's just happening kind of natural in a way, because when you have made one album, we usually meet together in the rehearsal room after a couple of weeks and just start to play. You know, just start somewhere, you know, someone has a bass line or some chords. And we just start there, and maybe we got some ideas that should be, okay, we should maybe try to make it more jazzy, or maybe we should go into the psycho core thing, or is there things in this music that gives us ideas for songs that can match together with it in a way.
Thank you. fatherless delay. Mine game for ghosts yesterday. Upstairs and downstairs, the mess is so complete. An equal share of chances and numbers. 7 years. Project on you like anything, impress you while I can. Tell me now what I like the best. Sweet indulgent, not grotesque, I'll forgive you anything. And really hope to make it up to you someday. Lest the game it happened yesterday. Lest the game it happened yesterday. The moon is not as hollow as they say.
This is my moist backyard. And this is the pool. And as a good nationalist Norwegian, I got a pair of wooden shoes for him. nasty one. I'm sorry. But wooden skis, so we're practicing ski jumping this season, but mostly indoors.
Did it get more difficult for you to go on tour with having a family and things like that?
It's a different situation, yes. It's sometimes it could be very hard, you know, feel this kind of loss or whatever. But I don't think Motorpsycho is it's not a subhuman machinery, you know. I could easily have children, and the others are really patient with the situation. I don't have to be forced to go on tour and stay away in 18 months period of time or anything like that. Everybody come up the stairs, he says.
Is there a song on a new album which is specifically yours?
Then it must be the Upstairs Downstairs song. It's pretty much about my little world here. I thought about this environment. The first line that lyrically popped up was upstairs and downstairs, the mess is all complete, and it is a very physical description of what was going on here, because both apartments were like in complete catastrophe state, you know.
How would you describe the development Motorpsycho has been going through?
Listening back to tracks like Demon Box and Flesh Are Over, which we would not be physical able to perform today in a way.
Why not?
I don't know. We were just other people. It was other lives. It seems it's not so many years ago, but anyway, if they say that you change every cell in your body every 7 years or what is it? it does not go for the brain cells, they say. Unluckily. Shit. No, but it was we were other people then. We had other thoughts.
What
and
changed then?
I mean, the need to yell people in the face and just have this very powerful, energetic, sometimes extremely aggressive output. yeah, you get some kind of drained and emptied, and we felt that it came to a natural end, that kind of that way of doing things. But I'm not saying it won't happen again, you know. Stuff that Bent and Gebhardt and sometimes me sit alone and figure out how to do it and then present it to the others, and then you can generate something more. Creativity. Where is it? I'm gonna find it. Yeah, but I'm trying every possibility to make stuff, to contribute, and will continue to do so till someone kicks me in the face and say, "You're dead."
Bulb up there, that's me. I can't see it now. Okay. Go in here.
This is the first bass I ever bought. I got it when I was 14 years old. That's the body. I broke the neck once.
What kind of music were you into when you...
When I got that, I think probably the first thing that I played on that bass was an AC/DC song, because they were really easy. I didn't know how to play a bass, so I had to sit down with AC/DC records and learn how to play. And it's a good Fender Precision bass. The whole country record I did on this, you know, it's like, it's perfect for that.
Which record was that?
The Tussler. Did that
through that bass and a guitar amp instead of a bass amp. So it's really, really light. It doesn't really sound heavy or bassy at all. It's just like another instrument.
What did you make you decide to make country records?
We've always had this thing about good music being good music, whatever it might be. And good country and western is good music in my book. And when we made the Demon Box, we were sort of perceived as the most heavy, you know, obnoxious rock band in Norway, at least, you know. And we thought, fuck no, we're not about that. We're more than that. And so we figured out, okay, let's just take it one step further and throw a country and western album on them. And we did. And it really confused a lot of people, to put it mildly. And what it basically is that it's a few cover songs, and it's also country and western versions of some of our own music. It's hard to tell if there's any Norwegian cultural stuff that has inspired us or influenced us in any way. Some of the modality and some of the music that we do relates to some old Norwegian folk music, but it also relates to Indian folk music or African folk music. So it's just this thing. But I cannot say that there's anything Norwegian in what I do as such. And I'm not really too concerned about it either, because I need to communicate with the whole world in a way. It's not limited to Norwegians. So, but I mean, if people perceive it as such, that we are a very typical Norwegian band and Norwegian sounding, then that's fine with me. I mean, if you want to go to, you know, the cliches, you can always put on some sort of wind machine on your recording and make it Arctic, you know. The way we run our band is probably very Norwegian. The trying to stay away from the music business, taking care of everything yourself, being very autonomous in the way you run things.
What's the advantage of being
a three-piece?
Yeah.
A lot of the stuff that we do when we play shows is that we improvise. So we use the songs as a framework for improvisation, and then when we go off, nobody knows. We know what key we're in, hopefully, or most of the time we do. And then we just go, and so it's just all on feel. And if the fourth guy or whoever isn't up to scratch, then it won't work. It'll limit us in a way. And the three of us, we have this thing that we know so well by now. I know, you know, I could almost tell which drum break he's gonna play and what, you know, type of note he's gonna play, you know, stuff like that. And so it's really fast, and that makes some of the magic.
With four-piece bands, it's usually there's one leader or two leaders and two people behind it, and three-piece bands there's three
There's only one leader in this band too.
Yeah,
that's me.
That's me. I am the only one who can take the tempo slow. You know, if they are not being nice, I just go down on tempo.
So yeah.
No. Just play along anyway. We've been busy now for a year making a new album, and it's really hard to say what the next challenge will be. It's going to be probably to just start up again and see where the music takes us. Hopefully we can get some new areas to enter where we haven't played before.
But did you think about what the audience will make of it, the new style Motorpsycho?
No, never. We just, our main concern has to be ourselves always. I mean, if the music is not interesting for us, then how could it possibly be interesting for anybody else? That's sort of the main idea. So we have to keep it fresh for ourselves, and then people will just follow, you know, or they won't. And it doesn't really matter, because for every fan we lose, we sort of, it seems like we gain too.
Yeah.
You know, it's really, it's amazing. Every album that we ever made sold a little bit more than the last one before it. And it's sort of been on an uphill rise all along. I've seen reviews in German papers where we've been sort of, this band sounds a bit like Motorpsycho. And in the early days, it used to be Motorpsycho sounds a lot like this and that and this and that. Now it sort of seems like it's turned a bit, so they use us as a frame of reference in a way. And that's nice, you know, to be sort of one of those bands that has some sort of identity that you can use as a reference when you talk about music. Then you sort of have achieved something, I guess. I don't know.